From JBS Studios in Greater New York, this is the JBS News Update with Teisha Bader.
I'm Teisha Bader with the JBS News Update for Thursday, August the 18th, 2022. Israel's Prime Minister Yair Lapid spoke last night with Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan shortly after Lapid announced, as we reported to you yesterday, that Israel and Turkey had agreed to restore full diplomatic relations. Lapid's office said the two leaders thanked one another and congratulated one another on the decision. Prime Minister and the President agreed that this latest development is an important additional level in the strengthening of relations that will lead to many achievements, especially in the fields of commerce and tourism. Lapid's office saying this will be reflected in the resumption of Israeli flights to Turkey and the upcoming convening of the Joint Economic Commission in Israel in September. The leaders emphasized the great importance of Israel and Turkey for maintaining regional stability. And Lapid spoke today with German Chancellor Olaf Scholz, this after remarks, as we reported to you yesterday, during Palestinian Authority President Mahmoud Abbas's visit and press conference with Scholz in Berlin, where Abbas accused Israel of quote-unquote 50 Holocausts against the Palestinians, later following outrage, retracting the remark. Scholz, who remained silent at the time of the press conference, later condemned Abbas's accusation. And in the call today, Lapid's office said that Scholz emphasized that he rejects and condemns Abbas's remarks and that it was important for him to clarify this personally to the prime minister as well as publicly. Lapid's office said the prime minister thanked him both as the prime minister of Israel and as the son of Holocaust survivors. Lapid also spoke to the German chancellor about the current talks with Iran regarding a possible return to the nuclear deal, which Israel firmly rejects. Lapid stressed to Scholz the need for Europe to send a clear and unequivocal message that there will be no more concessions to Iran and that Europe must oppose Iran buying time in negotiations. The Times of Israel reported that Lapid also spoke today on the issue with a number of U.S. officials, including U.S. Ambassador Tom Nides and Florida Congressman Ted Deutch, who serves as chairman of the House Subcommittee on the Middle East, North Africa, and Global Counterterrorism. And the Prime Minister's office shared today that for the first time in the history of Israel's intelligence agency, the Mossad, two women are serving in key senior positions, the head of the Iran desk and the head of the intelligence authority, which is basically the equivalent of the head of military intelligence in the IDF. The two women, only referred to by their first initials for security reasons, are each veterans of the agency. Mossad Director David Barnea said it is important for the Mossad, as a security organization that stands at the forefront of operations on behalf of national security, to inform women of the unlimited possibilities for them in the organization and to be an example for other security organizations regarding the integration of women into key roles. An Israeli startup is partnering with a Florida aerospace company to help solve the problem of creating and storing oxygen on the moon. Helios, which is backed by the Israel Space Agency, is based in Sur Yigal in central Israel, and Ada Space is based in Rockledge on Florida's Space Coast. Their mission is to help make missions to the moon more cost-effective, using a technology created by Helios that produces oxygen from the lunar soil, something called molten regolith electrolysis. Yisrael Hayom cited Helios CEO and founder Jonathan Gafman, saying this new collaboration with Ada Space will, for the first time, connect two purely commercial links in the chain, the production and the storage of oxygen, thus making multiple and long-term missions to the moon closer to being economically viable. Looking at some sports news, 19-year-old Israeli swimmer Anastasia Gorbenko won gold Tuesday in the women's 200-meter individual medley for the second year in a row at the European Aquatics Championships taking place this year in Rome, with a time of just under a second longer than last year of 2 minutes, 10 seconds, and 92 milliseconds. Gorbenko is a multi-medal winner with golds won at a number of events, including at last year's World Swimming Championships in Abu Dhabi, where she became the first Israeli to win 2 gold medals. Taking a look now at our programming for tonight on JBS for Thursday, August the 18th at 7 o'clock, it's Talmud Study. At 7:30, it's the Dershow with Alan Dershowitz. At 8, Jonathan Tobin speaks to author Batya Ungar-Sargon about the woke media. At 9, Mark Golub sits down with Brooke Goldstein on L'chaim. At 10, Erez Sherman speaks to Jacob Emrani about the power of sports to transform community for good. And coming up next, it's Good Week Israel. And that's the JBS News Update for Thursday, August the 18th, 2022. I'm Teisha Bader. Stay healthy, stay well.